Welcome back to Spiller Tutorial Services. Let's get busy. Today we're going to do a construct of a parallel line to L. And the parallel line has to also intersect or go through point P. So let's begin here with our straight edge, and we're going to create a transversal, which is nothing more than just a line that's going to intersect this point P, and it's also going to go through line L. So let's construct that. Alright, once point P is constructed, once this transversal is constructed going through P, now let's go ahead and pull out our compass tool. We need to set the radius to the compass to some arbitrary length, and then we need to go ahead and set this first at this intersection here. And you know what, let me label that intersection so it's easily talked about. Let's call this here intersection A. So once the pointy end is at intersection A, let's create an arc that intersects line L and also the transversal. Without changing the radius, let's move the compass here up to point P, and let's do the same thing. Create an arc here, and we want this arc to intersect our, whoops, let me fix that radius. We want this arc here to intersect this transversal in two different locations as such. Alright, now what we need to do is let's take the compass here and we need to reset the radius. This time we want the radius to be the length from this point in the arc to this point here in the arc. And let's see if we can get this as close as possible. Alright, that there is going to have to work for the video. We could do it, we could be a little more accurate by hand, but with this tool here, that's as accurate as I can get. Now, let's move the compass here up to this intersection point where I need to create another arc, and where these two arcs intersect is where I need to create another straight line. So let's pull this straight edge over, let's change its orientation, and we need it to go through point P and also through this intersection point. And let's see how close I can get that. I need this to be a little bit more precise. Let's slide this down some and see if that can help us out. Alright, and then let's move up. Alright, that there should be good enough. And now let's draw a line that intersects those two positions. Alright, let's put these two items away. What I want to do now is let's just go ahead and call up the protractor tool, because with the protractor, what I want to do is I want to measure this angle here, and I want to measure this angle here. If those angles are the same, that means those two lines are in fact parallel. Let me also get rid of some of these extra markings here. So we get rid of that arc, get rid of this arc, and get rid of this arc down here. So as I was saying, I want to make sure that this angle here is the same measure as this angle here. Alright, let's pull out this protractor tool and let's go ahead and change the size of it a little bit. Let's shrink it down some. Alright, so basically with what we've created here, I'm going to measure this angle. Alright, and we see this angle here measures approximately, let's see, that's 80, 81, 82. I'm going to say about 83 degrees. And then let's move down here to the bottom and measure this one. Again, let's put this here on zero. And we see we're about 81, 82, 83. That's about 84. But again, like I've said in the other videos, we're working by hand. And here I can't get as precise as I need to with some of these tools. But this here is proving that with these steps, we can construct a parallel line to L that also goes through point P. And as always, guys, thank you for watching. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel. And also like our videos here on Facebook. Thank you again for watching.